Did you know that you can make an electroscope using everyday household items? It's easy! I'll show you how.
Let's do some science!
Let's start with a list of things that we'll need. A medium-sized clear plastic jar with a plastic lid. Look for a mayonnaise jar, or maybe one that holds applesauce. This one is about 11.5 centimeters tall. A wire coat hanger. A pair of pliers that has a wire cutter. A hobby knife or scissors. Ruler. A paperclip. Some aluminum foil. A piece of paper. A freshly sharpened pencil. Tape. Also, any plastic or rubber items that you have, like a comb or a balloon to test the electroscope. And finally, a tube. If you don't have one, then anything else that's woolen will work too, like a mitten or a ball of wool.
Science!
Okay, now that we're ready, our first step is to take the pliers and, using the cutter, we'll cut a straight piece of wire from the coat hanger. Let's make it about 20 centimeters long. Great! We'll set that aside for now. Using the tip of your scissors, make a small hole in the middle of the lid. It might be easier to hold the lid down on a flat surface. The hole should be wide enough to slide the wire through. There! That should do it. Now, take the wire and, using the pliers, bend one end into a small hook. About 2/3 down from the other end of the wire, make a 90-degree bend. About 3 centimeters from there, make another 90-degree bend. When that's done, thread the wire through the lid. The hook should appear just below the underside of the lid, and the first 90-degree bend should rest nice and flat on top. Perfect! And let's tape the wire onto the lid to hold it still. Great! Okay, we're going to take our sheet of aluminum foil and scrunch it into a ball. Attach it to the top of the wire like this.
Science!
All right, we're almost there. Next, we'll color a section of the paper using the side of the pencil. Once that's done, cut a rectangle out of the colored section. Make it about 2 by 4 centimeters in size and fold it in half. Now, starting at the fold, cut out the shape of an oval, but keep the fold. Using the tip of your paperclip, gently poke a hole near the fold, but not too close to the edge. Try and make the hole slightly bigger because we'll need to thread these through the paperclip. When we open this up, we'll have 2 paper oval shapes. Woo! We are going to separate these by cutting along the fold and slide them onto the paperclip. Nice! Check to see that the colored sides are facing each other and wiggle them around to make sure each paper oval shape can move freely about. Hang the paperclip back onto the hook of the wire and reattach the lid to the jar. Okay, now, we're going to create an electric charge. Grab your woolen item and rub it against your hair. Rub your plastic item with the wool. Now bring this item close to the aluminum ball. You should see that the paper oval shapes will start to move away from each other. The closer you bring your item to the aluminum, the bigger the movement!
Science!
To bring the paper oval shapes back together, gently touch the aluminum ball with your finger. This will neutralize the charge. Play around with different variables to see what happens. You could change the material used for the paper cutout, the shape of it, its size. Bring other materials near the electroscope, like a bamboo brush, or try a balloon. Be creative and experiment on your own. And that's science!